Welcome, PQ.
Q.
Yeah,
it's
glad to be here.
Here.
Yes. What's that piece of paper?
This is what we're going to be working from on this series of, and thanks for watching, videos that will hopefully both entertain and enlighten and give you an idea of what kind of opinions both the Knowald and the River Guy might potentially have.
And for the viewers out there, since these will be an ongoing series, if you have any questions, feel free to do that in the comment section below, and we will, in subsequent programs, answer your deepest questions. And do make them deep, please.
Indeed. Now, a real simple question, something we can both give our own thoughts on. Why make art?
That's a very easy question, and since I am from the Tolteca tradition, the first requirement of your DNA, of your conception, is that you are an artist. If you are not an artist, meaning in the plastic arts of painting, drawing, sculpting, architecture, you are not in the Tolteca lineage. The lesser arts, and they are arts of healing, curing, dancing, those are lineages that remove themselves from what we consider the real Tolteca, which are stalking, dreaming, and intent manifested in your visual art offerings. Now, you probably want to know why visual arts. Well, it's an obvious answer, because for future sorcerers, they have been left by the ancient Tolteca sorcerers, pyramids, murals, and things carved out of stone in many cases, because those offerings will assist in future generations of sorcerers being able to see, while the dancers, the curers, the healers, all of them have faded away, other than through verbal passing on of the trades. But in order to have something in the plastic arts, that means no human needs to be present anymore. It still moves the assemblage point of the viewer, simply being in the presence of the pyramid, simply being in the presence of the painting. And in that way, not only do they last the longest on the earth dam, they also have the impact for the longest period of time. And they're really not dependent on the human being present. Now, as far as artists generally, you as an artist, also PQ, you know, I would think that still around the world, museums holding contemporary paintings, or we both love the great masters of comic books, movies now, all those things are visual offerings, music, sound, and vision, that now can be preserved on the internet, and that way move future artists in a way that the pyramids and stone do, and the fact that these products are not, say, enshrined in stone, they are enshrined in the ethers. Like the show we're doing today, for example. Let's see how long that lasts.
Well, everybody can be a publisher now. Which, you know, this is another revolution like when Gutenberg invented moving type.
Correct. Now, how many people out there, though, are from the artist lineage? I have to ask myself in searching the internet, how many are related to my Tolteca lineage using the internet?
Well,
how many of them are putting offerings out there that are still connected to that? And I can tell you, River, to my great sadness, sadly, are not artists.
Well, and when you come back next time, we'll address one of your questions. And the next time you see us, you let us right into what we'll talk about the next time. What isn't art?